Well, essentially, I wanted to make a film about what it was like for me growing up in Scotland as a young guy, in my teens. But it was like an opportunity to make a kind of love letter to my big sister and her pals. You know, it was, these were the girls that I grew up with, and I thought they were amazing. I thought they were loud, noisy, everything. And I thought, this was before mobile phones, and the kind of life that we had then was slightly different. It's not that long ago. So I wanted to make a film about that, something that was about my country, it was about my way of life, my background. And I didn't really care, you know, I don't care if anybody else liked it. I thought I would like making it, you know. I made a decision very early on that really what I wanted to try and convey was this kind of invisible energy that groups of young girls have between them. And it's I can see it as an outsider. I'm a man, of course. But I could see it, and I thought this was kind of unique. And I had to try and find a way to create that invisible energy. The only way I could do that was actually making them friends and really making them work very hard. It was hard work. But if something looks easy, it's usually been worked on quite a lot. And these were the most fantastic actresses. These are some of the best actresses of the generation, and I really was lucky as hell to get them. And they educated me as a man to a greater extent what it was like. So I can't say I made the whole thing. It was a collaboration, and it couldn't have been. It is the way it is because of the people involved, and those girls deserve as much credit as it is going. The history of this film is that I read and bought the book 20 years ago, and I wanted to make it, and it was going to be a contemporary film. And because I couldn't get the money to make it for so long, it's now a period film. So that's the reality of it. I didn't feel particularly fetishistic about the 90s. I felt it is the backdrop, but the bigger thing for me was the universality of the story. This is a story that could have happened in the 60s, 70s, 80s, whenever. That if I got that part of it right, then that would be more important than the nostalgic 70s, 90s aspect of it is really, to me, just an environment. It's not the point of it.